Performing Gaming 420.
In the endless reaches of the universe, there once existed a planet known as Krypton, a planet that burned like a green star in the distant heavens. There, civilization was far advanced and had brought forth a race of supermen whose mental and physical powers were developed to the absolute peak of human perfection. But there came a day when giant quakes threatened to destroy Krypton forever. One of the planet's leading scientists, sensing the approach of doom, placed his infant son in a small rocket ship and sent it hurtling in the direction of the Earth just as Krypton exploded. The rocket ship sped through star-studded space, landing safely on Earth with its precious burden, Krypton's sole survivor. A passing motorist found the uninjured child and took it to an orphanage. As the years went by and the child grew to maturity, he found himself possessed of amazing physical powers. Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. The infant of Krypton is now the man of steel. Superman! To best be in a position to use his amazing powers in a never-ending battle for true justice, Superman has assumed the skies of Clark Kent, mild-mannered reporter for a great metropolitan newspaper.
Kent, I want to see you. Just received another threatening note.
Okay, Mr. White.
Lois, another note from the mad scientist.
Coming in, Chief.
Now listen to this warning. He plans to strike tonight. Beware, you fools. My electrothanasia ray strikes tonight at 12. Total destruction will come to those who laughed at me and failed to heed my warning. Beware. I strike at midnight. This nut may prove dangerous. Kent, you help Lois follow up her lead. She may have an angle on this thing.
Yes, sir.
But, Chief, I'd like the chance to crack the story on my own.
Well, no.
Thanks, Chief.
But, Lois. Chief, don't you think that's a dangerous mission?
Thank you.
I'm a reporter for the...
A story. I'll give you the greatest story of destruction the world has ever known.
Looks like a job for Superman.
Human. Congratulations, Lois. That was a great scoop.
Yes, Chief. Thanks to Superman.
Faster than a speeding bullet, more powerful than a locomotive, able to leap tall buildings at a single bound, this amazing stranger from the planet Krypton, the Man of Steel, Superman! Empowered with X-ray vision, possessing remarkable physical strength, Superman fights a never-ending battle for truth and justice, disguised as a mild-mannered newspaper reporter, Clark Kent.
Lois, what are you doing here?
Oh, just getting the woman's angle on this story.
The mechanical monster! Look out!
Phone this in.
Hello? Yes, I'll give you the details later, Chief. All right, Lois. Lois! This is a job for Superman.
This is going to make.
The jewels. What have you done with the jewels?
You'll read about it in tomorrow's paper.
Are you going to tell me what happened to those jewels?
Tell me.
You'll soon change your mind.
Superman. She's doomed.
Thank you.
That's a wonderful story, Lois.
Thanks, Clark, but I owe it all to Superman.
Faster. I can't go with you, Lois, but I have another story to cover.
Oh, that's all right, Clark. I'll see you in the office.
Thank you.
like a job
for Superman. Superman turns up just when you need him.
I didn't even get a chance to thank him.
It's a plane! It's Superman!
penetrating deep into the frozen wastes of the great Arctic plains, an archaeological expedition searching for prehistoric fossils makes an amazing discovery. A huge monster, as lifelike in appearance as when it roamed the Earth millions of years ago in the Mesozoic Age, is found frozen in the ice in a state of perfect preservation. Constantly handicapped by the hazardous sub-zero elements, the scientists and their band of tireless workers succeed in removing the mammoth creature from the frozen pit. The ice-encased monster is loaded into the hold of a huge freighter equipped with a special refrigeration plant and brought to this country. Here, in a specially constructed wing of the Museum of Natural Science, this awe-inspiring creature is displayed to the public for the first time.
To say that if the ice were permitted to thaw, there's a possibility the monster might still be alive? Thank you, Professor.
Yes, Chief.
Lois, there's a new angle on that frozen monster story. Get over to the museum and see what's doing. They've got him in a special refrigerator.
Okay, Chief.
Oh, Lois, want me to go over there with you?
No, thanks. You'd probably faint if you saw the monster. You scare so easily.
Maybe she's right, but Superman hasn't fainted yet.
N produces the necessary refrigeration. The control board is downstairs. I'll show it. The entire plant is operated from this board. The thermometer must be watched constantly, as any rise in temperature might prove dangerous.
Cut those switches!
Boy, what a story!
Everybody, step lively, please. Use the nearest exit. Please, folks, keep moving. We have to clear this room at once.
That's what he thinks.
Police headquarters. Hello, Chief. Send the riot squad. We're in trouble.
Give me the city desk. Hurry!
Proceed to pick the men at once.
Chief, Lois is in the museum.
Better get over there, Kent.
Right.
This looks like a job for Superman.
Superman.
You'd better get back to your office where you'll be safe. I've got some work to do.
Yes, sir. And this the best story in years? Swell chance.
Stay put.
Yes, my lord. And thanks.
You showed plenty of courage getting that monster story, Lois.
Thanks, but where were you?
Me? Oh, I must have fainted.
Send in Lois Lane and Clark Kent. Give me a follow-up on this bullet card story.
Attention. The destruction of your police station today was only a small demonstration of our power. Unless your mayor turns over the entire funds of the city treasury, power plants, firehouses, and all municipal buildings will be next.
Take heed. This is your last warning.
What are the authorities going to do about this, Mr. Mayor?
We won't be intimidated by criminal threats. Law and order must and will prevail.
This looks like a job for Superman.
Thank you.
Another great scoop for you.
It was easy. Thanks to Superman.
Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings in a single bound.
Think of the professor's show now.
I still think it's pretty dangerous business.
Hope nothing goes wrong.
Gentlemen, that the safety of the public is of special import to you. Perhaps almost as important to you as my ambitions are to me. But you request that I give up my experiments, experiments which are the culmination of 30 years of dreaming and planning is impossible. Tonight, those dreams will become real. The comet of Falcon will be my toy. Under my control, it will be brought to within a mile of us. Then, after a close examination, I'll send it back again into space.
You're tampering with nature and endangers thousands of lives.
Yes, and even at the possible cost of those lives, I shall continue my experiment.
I warn you, Professor. We're prepared to stop you.
And I warn you, sir, any interference may prove disastrous. Stop!
We'll bring it crashing to Earth any minute. Stop! Do you hear?
Editor.
Look, Chief. The panic's gone. The thing's gone haywire.
Lois. Lois, what happened? Lois.
Are you all right?
Yes, for the moment, but...
Lane, the control.
Superman, you were wonderful.
You're pretty wonderful yourself.
Oh, how did you get here?
Thanks to Superman.
Thank you. I still say Manhattan rightfully belongs to my people.
Possibly, but just what do you expect us to do about it?
You have a newspaper. Publish the truth. Have the island vacated immediately.
It's fantastic.
Why, that's ridiculous.
Ridiculous? Maybe modern science will make you think differently.
I've never heard anything so absurd.
You know, from the look in his eyes, I'd almost believe he was in earnest.
No, he's just a harmless crank.
Come ahead, Miss Lane. You wouldn't want to miss this story, I'm sure. Cautionary measure. Get ready for the greatest story of your career.
Come on, Kent. Let's get out of here.
Looks like a job for Superman.
Thank you.
there. A girl is still down there.
Island looks just as good as ever.
That's right, Clark. Thanks to Superman.
For a murder or fire or something.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. Step right up and
get your cue, Lois.
The show is about to start. Only a few minutes before the performance begins. Oh, hurry, hurry, hurry.
Thank you.
going, Joe. Let's see what's cooking. This is a job for Superman. Lucky Lois always gets her story.
And luckily, she lives to write it.
Thanks to Superman.
Superman!
Lane of the Daily Planet.
Clark Kent, Planet.
And in operation, this stabilizer is one of the most effective yet devised, representing an investment in years.
How'd you like to be making the test flight in this, Lois?
Maybe I will.
Fine chance.
Everyone off, please. Everyone off.
Come on, Lois. That's us. Say, by the way, Lois. Lois.
Nothing will interfere with voyage to Tokyo. Help! Help! Japs are stealing the giant bomber. Hurry up!
Attention, all pilots. Giant bomber being stolen. Take off immediately.
Well-placed bomb will stop pursuit.
Ah!
This looks like a job for Superman.
You are. Leave plane immediately, or girl will be released.
Okay, little man. You win. Safe in this plane, Lois.
I'd feel much safer if Superman were here.
Faster than a streak of lightning. More powerful than the pounding surf. Mightier than a roaring hurricane.
Stupid. It's about time you showed up. Come on, come on, hand it over.
Okay, boss. Here it is. This is a swell racket, boss. And this Superman outfit, it works like a charm.
boss. It was only a fin.
Next time, it'll be a Mickey fin.
Friend turns foe. Well, that's ridiculous. It couldn't be Superman. What do you make of it, Clark?
Hey, you two. The editor wants you to cover the opera tonight. And don't forget, it's formal.
Good. Now I can wear my new evening gown. It is Superman.
Well, my double's in for some trouble.
Enjoy the opera? What's the matter, stupid? Did you lose your tongue? Don't stand there like a dummy. Give me the jewels. Or are you trying to double-cross me? Why, you...
Hey, boss, that's Mr. Superman.
Well... I didn't expect to see you here.
Thank you.
play Superman.
Boy, have I got a story. What's the matter, Bright Eyes? Did the opera get you down?
Just been dreaming I was Superman.
Fine Superman you'd make.
Well, I can dream, can't I?
In the endless reaches of the universe, there once existed a planet known as Krypton, a planet that burned like a green star in the distant heavens. There, civilization was far advanced and had brought forth a race of supermen whose mental and physical powers were developed to the absolute peak of human perfection. But there came a day when giant quakes threatened to destroy Krypton forever. One of the planet's leading scientists, sensing the approach of doom, placed his infant son in a small rocket ship and sent it hurtling in the direction of the Earth just as Krypton exploded. The rocket ship sped through star-studded space, landing safely on Earth with its precious burden, Krypton's sole survivor. A passing motorist found the uninjured child and took it to an orphanage. As the years went by and the child grew to maturity, he found himself possessed of amazing physical powers. Faster than a speeding bullet. Disguised as a mild-mannered newspaper reporter, Clark Kent.
Clark, do you suppose...
Yes, Lois?
Oh, nothing. Just a silly hunch that maybe Superman might be over here.
Quiet! Do not talk! Shanasta! The sabotage must stop at once! Konetawa!
We'll be right back.
ikioi! Kono sahen no koto! Itu mitsuke te aui wa!
Just saw him.
Swell chance they've got of catching him.
Kent, did he get away?
No. No, he's still over there. But don't worry, Superman promised to look after him.
Faster than a streak of lightning. More powerful than the pounding surf. Mightier than a roaring hurricane.
Thank you. in the wake of a series of baffling crimes, the body of an elderly man has just been found in the marsh flats outside the city. He has been identified as the watchman at the Metropolis Munitions Plant.
There's a story, or I'm no reporter.
He is believed to be the victim of an organized ring of saboteurs. More news later.
Huh, sounds like there might be a story at the plant, Lois.
Lois? Me name is Lois, not Lois. Chief Wiz, everybody interpolates me name wrong. It's Lois. L-O-U-I-S. Lois. Louise. Lucy. Now I'm so mixed up, I don't know who I am.
Okay, watchman. Take your post in the main shop and be on the alert.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Oh, pardon me.
Report upstairs, 12 o'clock. Very important. Report upstairs, 12 o'clock. Very important. I wonder what the big shot was.
That was a good job you did on the watchman last night. Now, how about that dynamite charge under the shops?
It's wired to the switch on the plant floor below. When the new watchman pulls that switch tonight, the whole place will...
Get that girl.
Now load in the dynamite.
Jones speaking.
Hello, Jones. We're ready for the test. Send out the torpedo immediately.
Immediately. Here comes the torpedo now. And that old hulk out there is a target. Naturally, for experimental purposes, there is no explosive in the torpedo. Okay, stand by. Ready?
Fire! Miss Lane, are you all right?
Superman, they're about to blow up the plant.
Hurry, throw that switch.
Superman put an end to their little act, and this puts an end to yours, Clark Kent.
In the endless reaches of the universe, there once existed a planet known as Krypton, a planet that burned like a green star in the distant heavens. There, civilization was far advanced and had brought forth a race of supermen whose mental and physical powers were developed to the absolute peak of human perfection. But there came a day when giant quakes threatened to destroy Krypton forever. One of the planet's leading scientists, sensing the approach of doom, placed his infant son in a small rocket ship and sent it hurtling in the direction of the Earth just as Krypton exploded. The rocket ship sped through star-studded space, landing safely on Earth with its precious burden, Krypton's sole survivor. A passing motorist found the uninjured child and took it to an orphanage. As the years went by and the child grew to maturity, he found himself possessed of amazing physical powers. Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. The infant of Krypton is now the man of steel, Superman. To best be in a position to use his amazing powers in a never-ending battle for true justice, Superman has assumed the disguise of Clark Kent, mild-mannered reporter for a great metropolitan newspaper.
Sick of this fool masquerade. I shall be glad when I'm finished with my work here.
Herr Kapitän, the submarine fleet commander is impatient for news of the American convoy.
He will be advised of its location shortly. To your post! By stealth!
Lieutenant! Lieutenant Fleming!
Miss Lane.
Yes?
Here, take these. Important papers. Destroy them. Mm-hmm.
American stubbornness. I give you just 10 minutes to remember what you did with those papers, or I will be forced to brighten your memory with fire. So?
So what?
Das ist genug.
Miss Lane's plane has reached the convoy by this time, hasn't it?
We're no soon, Mr. Kent. We're scheduled to meet the convoy ourselves in a few hours.
That's fine.
How's that, sir?
I said that's... that's fine.
I warned you, Fräulein. Unless you talk, I will make no effort to interfere with these natives.
Oh, cut the comic opera stuff.
Very well, Ngala. Even now, if you tell me the location of the papers, I can... I have them! Look! Your Yankee bravery was in vain! Hurry! Contact submarine fleet commander at once!
Yeah, boy.
Looks like they're having a party down there.
And us not invited. How do you like that?
What's that? It's Fleming's ship. Empty. I wonder.
The war
War Department goes on to say that during this action, an entire fleet of Axis submarines was destroyed by American dive bombers, affording the troop ships a safe crossing.
On the mighty mission, praise the Lord, and pass the ammunition, and we'll all be...
Faster than a streak of lightning. More powerful than the pounding surf. Mightier than a roaring hurricane.
And while on a hunting trip, my father discovered what are now known as the Henderson Caverns. More than 40 years ago, he mysteriously disappeared while exploring them further. Recently, I found these maps and charts he left, suggesting there are still greater wonders and mysteries lay beyond in this vast underground world. Now, if your paper will help finance the expedition, I will take Miss Lane and Mr. Kent with me and guarantee the Daily Planet exclusive rights to the story.
Sounds like a great story, Chief.
I'd love to go.
Well, let me see. All right, it's a deal.
Thanks, Mr. White. We can leave immediately. Careful now. Those are explosives for the blasting we'll have to do. We're shoving off, Kent. Meet you in the Blue Grotto.
So long, Clark.
See you later, Lois.
Lois!
above his head. Why, the resemblance is remarkable. Is that...
Yes, my father. But what would they be doing with a statue of him?
Henderson! Henderson! Henderson!
This is a job for Superman.
It's really a great story, Lois. But no one would ever believe it.
Faster than a streak of lightning. More powerful than the pounding surf. Mightier than a roaring hurricane.
Assignments, hurry over and cover that consumer's meeting.
But Chief...
But nothing. That's final.
was a close call. I've got to get to police headquarters immediately.
Ha! You're damnless and sharp, Skipper. I send you out to bring back that woman, and what happens? You let her get away and bring me this fool. She must not get to the airport. She must be stopped.
They are probably the largest and most ruthless gang of saboteurs in this country. I know. For 6 months they thought I was one of them. This briefcase contains a list of their names, together with their diabolical plans of destruction. They will stop at nothing to recover these records. I must get them through to Washington.
I understand. I'll see that you have an escort to the airport.
She's heading this way. Quick! She's trapped on the bridge.
But the place is surrounded by cops.
Hello! Edridge! Hello! Hello! Zum Donnerwetter! Something went wrong. We've got to get those records. Geworden? Zum Teufel! Was sollen wir tun?
Schmeiß die Wände ein!
Thank you. Pathfinder Gaming 420.